Latvia, small country, and in Latvia, as in quite a lot of the other Baltic countries, there's forms of music and forms of song which are kind of closer to an older layer of European culture. And it isn't just the songs. The people sometimes think that they talk about folk poetry. In Latvia, they have around about 2 million dainas. Dainas are like a verse. And in Finland, they have runo songs, which are in the same sort of idea. And in Latvia, there are more of these verses than there are people, actually. Each person would have, you've got one each. It's not just the lyrics, it's the way they're sung. And it's still in the villages, there are still old ladies who know how to sing these. And in different parts of Latvia, there are different traditions, there are different ways of singing. For example, one that I particularly like is in Celio, where there's a lot of parallel seconds. Now, if you sing a note and someone else sings a note one tone or a semitone away from that, close to you, weird things happen in your head. You get summation and difference tones. And so it's a participant thing as well as a listening thing. I suggest sometime after this, when you go home, just go, and get someone else to go, what tone or a semitone above or below that, and your head will ring in the most astonishing ways, particularly if you do it really loud. So Saucējas, which is the group you're going to see, they're going to show you songs actually from across Latvia, not just from that one region, but these are songs that go back a long way. The meanings of the songs are the things of the village or stories or whatever. And they will tell you some of what the songs are about as we go along. But the important thing to recognize is that this is part of European culture, which is really special and still to some extent living. Not all of these people in this group are kind of shepherds and shepherdesses or whatever. In fact, they're all S's, they're all female. But by learning to do this, and learning the power of it, they're not only preserving a culture, but giving a basis to what makes a Latvian Latvian, I guess. Not in a nationalistic way, but just what's special about these different regions, because most countries aren't just one culture, they're regions. So they're going to show you some of the different regional cultures, different regional ways of singing, all of them powerful. So I really would like you to listen to this and maybe try it at home just to see how it goes. Try using hard voices. So, Saucējas.
Thank you very much, Andrew Cronshaw. Once again, a round of applause for our introducer. Thank you. And now let's imagine we're not in a pub. We are somewhere outside and it's the beginning of spring. The snow has melted from the hilltops and we have just arrived in a horse-pulled carriage singing this riding song that you just heard. You find yourselves amongst groups of young men and women that sing and communicate to each other about the beauty of nature, about the beauty of people, sometimes heard kilometers away.
Thank you. Well, enough with the play, let's go to work. We all have been invited to a collective work somewhere in the eastern part of Latvia. You can do a good work if you don't have a good song. So here are some working songs. Thank you. Now I will invite you to join us to this drone voice. It goes like this. So the first one is O, then it's A, and then it's E. And you know, the work is only as good as the singing that comes along with it.
Oh!
Enough with the work, huh? Let's put the tools down and have a rest in a blooming meadow. And here we would like you to help us create these meadow sounds. The insects buzzing, like... Yes? The wind... Birds singing... Cuckoo! Cuckoo! For the first two songs, okay? That's fantastic. So again, you find yourselves amongst these groups of young women and boys that communicate, sometimes really kilometers away. You hear shepherds calling their animals, calling each other from the neighboring hills. Let's enjoy.
Smakosės diadajo, ai smakosės, žuvilėjo. Pīdi gaiši mēnesnīca, kār medu apmeties, lai es sevā.
It is winter now. It is the time of the winter solstice. And we have a tradition in Latvia that if a group of masked people visits your house, you will be happy all year long.
Thank you.
So a change of scenery again. And now we are all at a wedding. So there's lots of food, lots of drinks, singing, of course. But when the musicians, or in this case, singers, are tired, then there is one last dance for everybody to dance. So here are some wedding songs.
Thank you very much. Thank you. You have been the best audience and great help. Thank you very much. This was traditional. This was the traditional singing group from Latvia, Saucējas, and we really hope to see each and every one of you after the concert, okay?